How's everyone doing? Good. Are you good? Is everyone smiling? Let's see, who's not, you're not smiling. Where's your smile? You right here in the middle. Kyle, buddy, where's the smile? Can we get a little something, something going on? You're so awesome. Okay, how about you? You look like you're frowning a little bit. Can we turn that frown up like a little smile maybe? There it is, I love it. All right, and you guys are all, you're looking a little serious, but you want to smile. Yeah, I can tell, I can tell. Okay, let's start with, oh, here's the thing. So today, how do you feel about all Halloween stories? Are you into all Halloween stories? Yeah. Okay, that's good. But guess what? There's one story that is not at all related to Halloween that I'm hoping we can read just because I miss reading it out loud. Okay, so let's quickly start with Open, Shut Them, and then we're going to go right to stories. How's that sound? All right. Open, shut them. Open, shut them. Give a little clap, clap, clap. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Lay them in your lap, lap, lap. Creep them, crawl them. Right up to your chin, chin, chin. Open up your little mouth, but do not let them in. You let them in, but we don't even have time because we have too many Halloween stories to tell.
I didn't let them in.
You didn't? Thank you for not letting. You did though. No. Gracie, did you let them in? No? Okay. Good. Good. All right. So our first story is about, do you know what it's about? You tell me. Clifford, how did you even know it was Clifford? Because he's wearing a Halloween costume, right? And this is Clifford's Halloween. I'm Emily Elizabeth. Today is a holiday. It's my favorite day of the year. How about you guys? Is Halloween your favorite holiday?
Yeah.
It is? So who's a Christmas fan? You are? Okay. But Halloween, raise your hand if you're in love with it. Wow, not that many of you. Oh, all right. Now you're all starting to, okay.
I want to be a pirate.
Yeah, you can put me on that list too. This is my dog, Clifford. Today is his favorite day too. With a big red dog like Clifford, every day is fun. But holidays, well, they are the most fun of all. At Christmas, Clifford makes a very good Santa because he already has a red coat. And on New Year's Eve, we stay up until midnight so that Clifford can blow his New Year's horn. Oh boy, look what he did. Did he blow everyone across the room?
Yeah.
Oh, look, on Valentine's Day, Clifford's my favorite Valentine.
Clifford is the rabbit. Look for you.
What holiday must that be?
Rabbit.
It's rabbit holiday? And you should see Clifford on Easter. He makes a wonderful Easter bunny. I like the heart, Clifford.
I like the Easter.
I wish I could turn myself into a heart. On April Fool's Day, do you know what that holiday is? Have you heard of April Fool's Day?
No.
It's a day where you can play a trick on somebody. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Yeah? So on April Fool's Day, Clifford never plays tricks on anyone, but do the kids look like they're up to something?
No.
No?
Yeah.
They look like they want to play a trick, huh? And no one plays tricks on Clifford. But do you know why they say that? Because, look, Clifford was like, oh, a bone, I'm going to take it. And the little boy's like, wait. On Thanksgiving, Clifford gets a great big what?
Turkey.
A turkey. And even though we think it's big, do you think Clifford thinks it's big?
No.
In that dish? It looks pretty small. But today is the best holiday of all. Halloween! Last year...
Oh, pirate again.
Yep. Last year, we had a big Halloween party. I dressed as a pirate, but I didn't know how to dress Clifford. Daddy thought Clifford would make a good devil. See? He's got that little pointy tail. I wanted him to be a clown. Or maybe a witch. But do you know what Clifford wanted to be? Really? What makes you say that? Those curtains. You were right. He wanted to be a ghost. When the children came to the party, nobody could guess who the big ghost really was. Do you believe that?
Clifford.
It's totally Clifford.
It's silly.
So silly.
Silly.
We had fun. We bobbed for apples. Do you see what bobbing for apples is? Do you know what that is? You get a big tub of water and you put apples inside, and then you have to put your head in and get an apple without using your hands. Has anyone ever tried that before? It's really hard. Okay, it's so hard. You should try it sometime. It's very hard. And you know who else wanted to play?
Clifford.
I know. Oh, gosh. So they played another game with apples. And do you see that game where you put the apple on the string? Same thing. The apple hangs from the string and you have to try to eat it, but you can't use your hands. You think that would be hard?
Yeah.
With the apple moving around on the string?
Yeah, too hard for me.
Too hard? I bet you could do it though, don't you think?
I can.
Yeah?
I can.
And you know what? Clifford won that game. Then Mommy told us a ghost story, but we weren't afraid. We had the biggest ghost on our street taking care of us. After the party, Clifford and I went trick-or-treating. We didn't have much luck, though.
I wanted my house.
Oh, yeah? But we didn't mind. Do you see when they went trick-or-treating? What happened? What happened when they went trick-or-treating?
They ran away.
The people ran away, right? I don't know. Maybe he's really scary as the ghost. Well, it was time to go to bed anyhow. Halloween was over. And now Halloween has come again. I'm not going to be a pirate this year. This year, I'm going to be
a fairy
princess. But what should Clifford be?
Clifford.
What should he be? Should he be an Indian chief? Should he be a knight?
Oh, yeah.
That would be good. Well, what do you think?
Clifford.
Just Clifford? Okay, just Clifford. The end.
No one would run away from him.
That's true. What else do you think he would be good at, though, if he had to wear a costume? What about, What about do you think he could be a hockey player? A boat. I like it. Yeah. Do you think he could swim?
Yeah.
Maybe. He could do a doggy paddle.
Or a lion.
Oh, he'd be a good lion, right? Do you think so? I do too, yeah. What's that?
Maybe a ghost.
Ooh, a ghost. That might be his best costume yet. I agree. Okay. So... Here, do you all know Froggy? You know the frog? Have you ever read a Froggy story before?
No.
So Froggy's a very sweet frog, and he sometimes finds himself gets into some sort of mischief or trouble. Usually it's not too bad, but this is a story about his Halloween. For Froggy, Halloween meant candy. But it also meant dressing up. And he wondered, what should I be for Halloween? I know, cried Froggy. Super Frog! flying high over the city, faster than a dragonfly, stronger than a bulldog. No, something spooky. Ah, oh, I know, cried Froggy, a ghost frog.
I think he should be a
ghost. Ooh, he poked two holes in his mother's best white sheet and draped it over his head. Ooh, you think that's a good costume for him?
Yeah.
No, something scarier. I know, cried Froggy, I'll be a vampire frog. He put on his black cape, swoosh, pulled on his mom's black tights, zup, put on his slick black wig, zap, and said in his best Dracula voice, trick or treat, smell my feet, give me something good to eat. If you don't, I don't care. I'll pull down your underwear. Froggy, called his mother. What? Halloween's not till next week. You're supposed to be doing your homework, dear. I'm Count Von Frogula, said Froggy. Vampire frogs don't do homework. Froggy's mother laughed. Well, vampires have fangs, she said. You're a toothless wonder. Oops, cried Froggy, covering his mouth. He forgot he doesn't have fangs. Frogs don't have fangs, right? So all week at school, Froggy wondered, what should I be for Halloween? Should I be a football player? Should I be a cowboy? How about a zombie? Ooh, that's scary. Froggy, cried his teacher. What? Kindly keep your mind on your work, dear. But his mind was on Halloween. Every day after school, he got ready. He carved crazy pumpkins. He hung sticky spider webs all over the front of his house. He hung his mother's sheet like a ghost in the wind, and he practiced. Now, see if you can practice this with me. Trick or treat, smell my feet, give me something good to eat. If you don't, I don't care. I'll pull down your underwear. Oh no! At last, it was the night before Halloween, and all through the house there were creaking sounds and scratching sounds. And Froggy, well, he was a little bit scared. He shivered in his bed and imagined ghosts and goblins and werewolves and witches. Zap! I know, cried Froggy. I'll be the frog prince for Halloween. And in the morning, he put on his black cape, pulled on his mom's black tights, put on his slick black wig, plunked on a gold crown, and flashed his mighty sword. Ta-da!
I got
four. You do?
I got two of them.
That's so cool. What do you do with them?
Do you
pretend that you're a knight?
No, I'm pretending a pirate.
That's awesome. Okay, I love that. At the Halloween parade at school, all the girls thought that he looked cute, especially Frog Alina. Well,
where's that?
That's Frog Alina. And there's Froggy. And that night, when the dark crept in and all the ghosts and goblins crept out to trick or treat, boo! Princess Frogalina leapt out and chased after the frog prince to give him a kiss. Eee! Cried Froggy. He was never more scared in his life. Ah! He leapfrogged over his mother. He leapfrogged over his father. He leapfrogged over his friend Max and flopped up Max's steps. Flop, flop, splat. He tripped on the porch and Frogalina fell on top of him. Oh boy. The door flew open and up there stood the wickedest witch in the world. Trick or treat, squeaked Froggy, looking more red in the face than green. Luckily, Frogolina ran away and the witch turned out to be Max's granny. Well, that's not so scary, right? And that Halloween, Froggy got tons of candy, but his sword had torn a hole in his candy bag. And by the time he got home, do you see what's happening? What happened?
All the candy.
Yep. So by the time he got home, his candy was all gone. Isn't that the worst? Can you imagine? You go through all that work and then no candy. Oh no, cried Froggy. What's the matter? Asked his mother. He showed her his empty bag. Well, you're in luck, said his mother, holding up a big full bowl. I guess nobody liked my treats. What do you think she gave him? Take a look. What do you think her treats were? Chocolate covered flies. Cried Froggy. My favorite. Munch, crunch, munch.
That's what frogs eat.
Exactly. So do you think he probably liked them? Yeah, me too. Hooray. Did you like that one? You would like to eat them? No.
I would like to eat the candy.
You want some chocolate covered flies?
No candy.
Oh, I know. I'd like some candy
like
too.
I like
yeah. How about? Can we do another Halloween story?
Yeah.
No more stories.
Yeah.
All right. It's called Halloween. What is that?
A
jack-o'-lantern, that's right. I know, it's actually, I kind of think it's beautiful, but yeah, he's supposed to look a little scary. But does he look kind of friendly too? Or happy?
Happy.
Happy, I think so too. Tonight is the night when the dead leaves fly. Like witches on switches across the sky. When elf and sprite flit through the night on a moony sheen. Tonight is the night when the leaves make a sound. What do you think they sound like? Yeah. Like a gnome in his home, under the ground. When spooks and trolls creep out of their holes, mossy and green. Tonight is the night when pumpkins stare. Look at, do you see the bat? Kind of looks like a smile against the moon. Through sheaves and leaves everywhere. When ghoul and ghost and goblin host dance round their queen. It's Halloween! And that's the end. All right. That was a short one, huh? You guys, are you warm like me? It's hot, a little warm in here, huh? Do you think you have one more story in you?
Yep.
Yeah? All right. Can we read Madeline? That's the one I've been missing the most. You all know this story, right?
Yeah.
Madeline. I love it so much. You do? You have it. Oh, you don't. That's okay because we get to read it together, which is kind of awesome. It's okay if you don't have it at home. That's the great thing about your preschool and your library because we've got you covered. All right, Madeline. In an old house in Paris that was covered in vines, lived 12 little girls in two straight lines. In two straight lines, they broke their bread and brushed their teeth and went to bed. They smiled at the good and frowned at the bad. And sometimes they were very sad. They left the house at 9:30 in two straight lines, in rain or shine. The smallest one was Madeline. She was not afraid of mice. She loved winter, snow, and ice. To the tiger in the zoo, Madeline just said, "Poo poo."
That's not nice.
Oh. You're right, it isn't, but that's not how she meant it, actually. And nobody knew so well how to frighten Miss Clavel. In the middle of one night, Miss Clavel turned on the light and said, "Something is not right." Little Madeline sat in bed, cried and cried, her eyes were red, and soon after Dr. Cohn came, he rushed out to the phone. And he dialed Danton 10-6. "Nurse," he said, "it's an appendix." Everybody had to cry. Not a single eye was dry. Madeline was in his arm, in a blanket, safe and warm. In a car with a red light, they drove out into the night. Madeline woke up 2 hours later in a room with flowers. In a hospital? Oh, in Paris? Oh, really? Is that where you're from? No, that's so great. Do you remember it? Do you get to go back and visit? That's so great. They're right now? That, my goodness, I'm so glad we're reading this book today. Madeline soon ate and drank. On her bed there was a crank, and a crack on the ceiling had the habit of sometimes looking like a rabbit. Outside were birds, trees, and sky, and so 10 days passed quickly by. One nice morning, Miss Clavel said, "Isn't this a fine day to visit Madeline?" Visitors from 2 to 4 read a sign outside her door, tiptoeing with solemn face, with some flowers and a vase. In they walked and then said, "Oh," when they saw the toys and candy and the dollhouse from Papa. But the biggest surprise by far, on her stomach was a scar. "Goodbye," they said, "we'll come again." And the little girls left in the rain. They went home and broke their bread, brushed their teeth, and went to bed. In the middle of the night, Miss Clavel turned on the light and said, "Something is not right." And, afraid of a disaster, Miss Clavel ran fast and faster. And she said, "Please, children, do tell me what is troubling you." And all the little girls cried, "Boo-hoo! We want to have our appendix out, too!" "Good night, little girls. Thank the Lord you are well. And now go to sleep," said Miss Clavel. And she turned out the light and closed the door. And that's all there is. There isn't any more. The end. Hooray! You guys, give yourselves a round of applause. Well, I think we're all told out of stories, but I'd love to know, what are you all going to be for Halloween? Tell me in one big, just say it. What are you going to be? Okay, I want to hear, now I want you. Okay, now I'm going to ask all of you, one at a time. Okay, honey, are you going to go trick-or-treating? No? Okay, how about you, honey? Are you going trick-or-treating? What are you going to dress up as? You don't know yet. You're still thinking about it. And how about you? Trick-or-treating? What are you going to be? Do you know? A pumpkin! I'm going to guess. You're going to be Batman.
No.
You're going to be a baseball player.
No, a minion.
You're going to be a minion. Are you going to be a minion? Okay. How did he even know?
Kevin. He's going to be Kevin.
Oh, okay. And Buddy, what are you going to be? fireman. Oh, really? Are you guys having a little costume party tomorrow? That's so great. So wait, you said fireman. Okay, how about you? What are you going to dress up as? Roar. Do you have your roar practiced yet? Are you going to roar like a dinosaur? How are you going to do it?
Roar.
Ooh. All right. And how about, are you going to be a minion too? Oh. Wait, what are you going to
be?
Oh, a Bob. Oh, all right. And how about you? Elsa. Great. How about you? What are you going to be? Oh, an astronaut? That's so cool. Can I guess what are you going to be?
A policeman.
Oh, I never would have guessed that. Oh. Anne, what are you going to be? What's Anne going to be?
Candy.
She's going to be Candy. Oh, delicious.
Belle. She's going to be Belle.
You're going to be Belle?
Mm-hmm.
I like it. Wait, did she have a costume today?
Yeah.
I missed it. Oh, what color was her dress?
Yellow.
Wow, I love it. All right, let's see.
I
what
have a name.
Did you say what you were going to be yet? Tell me, please.
Pirate.
Pirate, how about you?
Mommy.
Are you trick-or-treating, honey?
Maybe. I'm trick-or-treating.
Butterfly. Okay, sweet. And what did you say?
Pirate.
A pirate. Oh, you're going to do the pirate. Is this the more than the first time? Are you a pirate every year?
Yeah.
Are you just like, Halloween, get the pirate costume out. You're going to be some sort of superhero.
No, I'm going to be Captain America for my party.
Yay, that's great. Do you have your costume?
Yeah.
Very cool. And how about you? What are you going to be?
I'm going to be a witch.
I love your glasses, by the way.
I'm going to be a silly ghost.
A silly ghost. Awesome. That's the best. Oh, a scary ghost? Whoa. Have you practiced being scary yet? Give me an, how are you going to do it? Show me. Okay. And how about you? What are you going to be? Roar! Give me your roar. Okay. And how about you? What are you going to be? Who? A transformer? Whoa. Okay. I don't think I've heard of that transformer before. That's pretty awesome. Do you have your costume yet? Cool. And how about you? What are you going to be?
A ladybug.
I'm going to be a witch.
You're going to be a witch? Like a scary witch? Ooh. Do you have the hat?
No, my mom has to get it first.
That's awesome. And how about you in the yellow? What are you going to be?
A dragon.
Ooh! Are you going to breathe fire? No. Gracie, what are you going to be? That's what you're going to be?
Yeah.
I love it. I can't wait to see that. Have you practiced it yet? That's going to be your fun costume. And how about, I think, yeah. Where are you going to be, honey?
Where
are
you going to be, Haley?
Yay. What color is your costume? Very lovely. You guys sound like you're going to have a great day. That's great. Oh, all right. Cyborg? Whoa. I still don't know what I'm going to be yet. I haven't decided. But, all right, you guys, give yourselves a round of applause again. I miss you guys so much. I'm so glad I got to read stories to you today. Hooray, hooray. Hello. You're welcome. I know, I feel like we're all getting lulled into a sleep right now because it's so warm back here. So this was your second